A small portion of this video is sponsored by NordVPN. So, who here remembers the Pebble Time? Unfortunately, I didn't get to use one of those legendary e-ink smartwatches before the company got bought out by Fitbit, but I may have found something even better. This is the Fossil Hybrid HR, a hybrid smartwatch that has both analog hands and an e-ink display behind them. These watches started popping up over a year ago, and somehow I managed to hear absolutely nothing about them until a few weeks ago, and I'm so glad that I finally did because this hybrid smartwatch might just be my favorite watch that I've ever owned. My particular model is the Collider Black, which comes with a black silicone band out of the box. Now, while that is a comfortable watch band, I prefer the look of this rather cheap leather band I got from Amazon for 20 bucks. The Hybrid HR takes just about any 22mm watch band, so it's a very easy watch to customize. The watch itself looks a lot like many traditional watches you'd find on the market, and that's part of the appeal. The outside ring around the watch, as well as the hands, are both physical. They aren't part of the e-ink display. Now, that might seem a little bit weird to you at first, since the hands can somewhat obscure the display, but if you just give your wrist a little flick, the hands will do a spin to get out of your way. To access the menu and navigate through the watch, you use the three buttons on the side. There's no touchscreen here. Long pressing the middle button will open up the main menu, and the hands will spin to the 9 and 3 positions. From there, you can open up the settings menu, ping your phone, or select one of several apps that come pre-installed on the watch. This is obviously not the fastest smartwatch on the market, given that it is an e-ink display and they have relatively low refresh rates, and sometimes they take an extra second to respond, but e-ink has a number of huge advantages over the LCD and OLED panels on a lot of modern smartwatches. For one, e-ink displays draw very, very little power. In fact, the only time they draw any power at all is when something on the display changes. For that reason, the Hybrid HR has a battery life of up to 2 full weeks. In my testing with all the notifications I get, I got about a day or two less than that, but honestly, it's still pretty incredible. If you do manage to forget to charge the Hybrid HR and it ends up dying on you, the watch won't even look dead. The e-ink display will continue to display the last thing that was on it, so you can continue to wear it without anyone noticing that you have a dead watch on your wrist. Naturally, the Hybrid HR's e-ink display can be customized in a ton of different ways. This is a custom watch face that I found online, and I'll leave links to it and the watch itself in the description below if you're interested. Inside the Fossil Hybrid app is where you'll find all the customization options. You can import your own faces or make your own. You can add text, stickers, all sorts of complications like weather, step counters, or battery life, and you can even take a picture to have it displayed on your watch. Of course, this is a black and white display, so color is not going to come through, but it's still pretty cool that they let you do that. I didn't bother customizing my own face because there's a ton of watch faces out there in the Hybrid HR community, and I'm pretty certain that anyone can find something they like. There's not going to be as many faces as a lot of Android Wear or Samsung Tizen watches, but there's definitely enough. The Hybrid HR comes with a little puck-style charging pad that will charge the watch from 0 to 100% in just over an hour. It's magnetic, so it's very easy to line up the charging pins, and it just snaps to the back of the watch. All right, I'm gonna move on to talking about all of the stuff that this hybrid smartwatch can do, like workout tracking, notification mirroring, the situation with taking phone calls, and all of that great stuff. But first, I need to take a quick minute to thank the sponsor of this video, NordVPN. You need to protect yourself online, and using NordVPN is one of the easiest ways to do it. It works by creating an encrypted and secure tunnel between your computer and the host that you're accessing, and you can get it by going to nordvpn.org/spurl or clicking on the link in the video description below. NordVPN has a lot of different uses, and it's available on almost every platform that you can think of. You can use it at home on your Windows PC or Mac, but you can also throw it on your Android or your iOS device to keep yourself protected while you're out and about on public Wi-Fi. The main reason I use Nord is to protect me from getting my personal or my banking information stolen, but it's got other uses too. For example, you can also use it to bypass region-locked content that you wouldn't normally be able to access. I'm Canadian, so Hulu isn't available in my country, but if I just switch to a US server, Hulu thinks I live in the US and I can bypass those restrictions in just a few seconds. Some people might be worried about losing speed when they connect to a VPN, but honestly, I haven't noticed a single difference between when my VPN was on and when it was off. Look, NordVPN is awesome, and you don't have to take my word for it. Just Google NordVPN reviews. It's got top ratings literally everywhere, and you should definitely get it. Use the link in the video description below, or use the promo code SPURL to get a 2-year plan plus 1 additional month with a huge discount. Thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring this video, and now let's get back to the Hybrid HR. Okay, so what can this watch actually do? Well, first of all, the Fossil Hybrid HR does heart rate and workout tracking, as the HR in the name would imply. It tracks steps, calories burned, heart rate, and it will track other metrics depending on the workout you select. For example, when I do some cycling, it'll track how far I went, my average and max speed, my average RPM, and where exactly I went. There's no GPS sensor in this watch, but it will use your phone's GPS to track you where you go. I compared the Hybrid HR's cycling workout tracking to my Apple Watch Series 5, and they actually lined up fairly well with only slight variations here and there in calories burned and distance traveled. The step tracking was a different story though. Compared to my Apple Watch, which by the way has way more sensors, the Hybrid HR was giving me almost double the amount of steps that the Apple Watch was reading, and as much as I would like to believe the Fossil Watch over the Apple Watch, there's no way that's accurate. As for other smartwatch features this watch has, it can also mirror notifications from your phone to your watch. The vibration is quiet, and it's so strong that it's difficult to miss even when you're working out. You can turn up or down the intensity of the vibration motors in the settings on the watch, and you can select which apps you want notifications from in the Fossil app. You can't really do anything with the notifications though, since this e-ink display is not a touchscreen. The notification will pop up and you can read or dismiss it with the buttons, but you'll have to actually pull out your phone to reply to a message or email. Same thing with a phone call. You can accept or reject the call, but you'll have to pull out your phone to talk to the person since there's no speaker or microphone in this watch. Unfortunately, the Hybrid HR software is limited to what Fossil's devs preload onto the watch. There's no third-party apps for the Hybrid HR, so what you see is what you're gonna get. The best way to describe these hybrid smartwatches is that they're much smarter than your average analog watch, but they're also a little bit dumber than your average smartwatch. For me personally, this watch is almost perfect. I think smartwatches should augment your experience with your phone rather than totally replace it. I'd need my watch mainly for three things. To tell time, duh. Send me notifications from my phone so I don't have to pull it out every time I feel a vibration, and to track my workouts. And this watch does all of that and looks pretty darn good while doing so. If you're okay with a somewhat limited feature set and you just want a good looking watch that handles the basics very well, the Fossil Hybrid HR is for you. But what's it gonna cost you? Well, at MSRP when this watch launched, it would run you just under $200 US, which is a little bit too expensive in my opinion for what the watch offers. Fortunately, the price seems to have dropped off quite a bit, and you can actually grab one for around 135 bucks right now, which is, in my opinion, totally worth the asking price. Like I said, this is one of my favorite smartwatches or hybrid smartwatches that I've ever owned. I love not having to charge my watch every single day, and I love that it looks like a traditional watch and has all of the basic features that I'd want from a smartwatch. It's got some setbacks for sure, but I still think the pros far outweigh the cons when it comes to the Fossil Hybrid HR. If you like this video and you want to compare it to an actual smartwatch, I highly recommend you watch my review of the Samsung Galaxy Watch 3. Who knows, maybe a full-on smartwatch is more your style. Thanks for watching, and as always, have a great day.